thank you for the kind introduction. I'm very fortunate to be a part of Howdy Fetus and as a organizing committee of AMOX 34 in Amravati. I welcome you all to Amravati, and I would first like to thank Somvanshi ma'am, Pranjal ma'am, Rashmikahar ma'am, Shubhangi Mundra ma'am, Mona ma'am, and entire team to having been given this opportunity to be at this workshop and being as a convener. It was a great experience and so many things to learn. So without wasting any time, there's a disclaimer. My topic for today is not fetal Turi echo, but why would you ask for it? Prenatal diagnosis of congenital heart defects has been suboptimal over the years, and this is because of the complexity of cardiac anatomy and the inherent difficulty of the ultrasound examination of the fetal heart. So why so much worry about congenital heart defects? It's a leading cause of infant mortality and most common congenital anomaly to affect the fetus and neonate. Half are severe enough to require surgical or catheter intervention. But we also know that prenatal diagnosis of CHD allows better pregnancy counseling and improves neonatal outcome. So where's the problem? The biggest hurdle we all know is the diagnosis. Traditionally, we have been asking for fetal echo to all our patients for all these indications, which are maternal, fetal, and we all know by heart where and when we need to ask our patients for a fetal echo, because we believe that these are all high risk for having babies with congenital heart defects. But believe me, majority of fetuses with congenital heart defects have no known risk factors. And in spite of this, fetal echo has been traditionally done alone with identifiable risk factors for the CHD. A very simple example here is our own GDM. We know that it has a lot of adverse maternal outcomes, and a lot of our Indian women have increased risk for it, and hence we are started doing universal screening for these. So why not for our CHDs, for prenatal detection? So from high risk to universal screening, the American Heart Association scientific statement states that only 10% of fetuses with CHD present for imaging with an identifiable risk factors. Hence, regardless of risk factors, all the fetuses should be approached as if they have potential to have cardiac malformation. Why screening at all? Certain cardiac lesions, as we know, the prenatal detection has a positive impact on the postnatal outcome. Also, there is reduction in either mortality or improved condition at presentation. Also, detection of other structural anomalies or karyotypic anomalies can be possible. Like, you can diagnose trisomy 21 when you diagnose a complete atrioventricular septal defect. You go ahead and diagnose it. Also, like 22q microdeletion when you detect a tetralogy of Fallot. To the parents, yes, it gives time to understand the nature of CHD, interventions required, and long-term prognosis. And depending on the severity of the lesion, gestational age, and the legal framework, they can have the option of termination of pregnancy. But how can we improve this detection of prenatal detection of CHD? The best way is the optimum cardiac screening. Every time the fetus is looked at, even the heart should be looked at as if there is a potential for a cardiac disease. Many international publications have come, and they are helping us to maximize the detection of heart anomalies during a second trimester scan. And it is specifically, they have mentioned that it is for evaluation of low-risk fetus examined as a part of routine prenatal care. It is done from 18 to 22 weeks of gestation. And this is a time when we are doing all our most routine mid-trimester obstetric ultrasound for all the fetal anomalies. So coming to the cardiac screening, the four-chamber view can be reliably obtained in 95 to 98% pregnancies and detects about more than 50% of serious cardiac anomalies. But we should understand that we need to the addition of outflow tracks and the three vessel trachea view increases the sensitivity to as high as 90%. And this is called as extended basic cardiac examination. This systemic approach involves a series of transverse cuts in the fetal chest in caudal to cranial direction, and it is the minimum basic protocol to be followed in every mid-trimester anomaly scan. I will show you in detail in after a few slides. So what first we'll see what it includes. Always remember, a fetal heart begins, the imagining or scanning begins from the fetal abdomen. So first and most we need to look at as cardiac situs. Then comes the four chamber view, left ventricular outflow tract, right ventricular outflow tract, the three vessel view and the three vessel trachea view. Most important is to understand the image pattern in the normal heart. So let us have a look. I have just kept a clip to just have an idea about it. So this is the fetal abdomen where we are starting. Here is the stomach, and this is on the left, we have noted. And this is the aorta and the IVC. So slowly we move ahead cranially, and we get the four chamber view, slightly tilting cranially. Still more tilting, the left outflow tract will open up. That is called a five chamber view, and you will get the LVOT. Little more cranially, and with slight angulation, will come the three vessel view and the three vessel trachea view. Again, little more tilting. Then coming back to LVOT, perpendicular to that, we'll get the RVOT. Both vessels are perpendicular to each other. That's the way the screening should be done. Go next. So fetal cardiac screening. This paper tells us about essentials of cardiac screening. Good image quality. What does it mean? Doesn't only mean that all the technical settings that we use, but also the fetal and the maternal position that we need to take into account, how much time we are giving for that scan. Also the probe placement and the pressure that we use at the time of screening. Angles of acquisition, the best example here would be when you want to look at the ventricular septum, the angle of acquisition should be perpendicular to the septum and not when it is in parallel, because then you miss out and label it as a defect there, or it will look like a defect. Use of a clips and sweeps should be done, encouraged, and definitely the experience and training of operator does matter with detection of CHDs. I am just mentioning little about the early fetal echo, but because this is also very important aspect now, screening at 11 to 13.6 weeks. Again, very simple use of color flow mapping. You look for the two inflows and the two outflows. So it is easily done by a good image optimization and color flow imaging. And this is what I would like to explain, because very important. This is the short right aortic arch, and this will be a long limb, which is the ductal arch. So when you go from, I'll show the clip for this. So this is what we need to see for the arch view. An early evaluation of the fetal heart is very, very easily done, and the planes can be obtained almost in about 100% of the fetus from 12 to 14 weeks of gestation. So this is the same way. Again, we look at the stomach on the left side. Go little cranially, you will get the four chamber view. Put color, the four chambers in colors, that is, you will see the two inflows, and little more cranially, you will get the two outflows. So minimum that we need to screen at 11 to 13 weeks is the situs, the inflows and the outflows. If at all you get something different, only one single inflow, single outflow, or something other than this, we need to suspect cardiac anomaly. We might not know which, or we might not diagnose which exactly it is, but at least a suspicion is important so that further we can refer the patient early. This is also one clip, very easy to understand. This is the stomach. I'm going little cranially just to look at the four chamber. Can see, appreciate those two inflows in red. And little more cranially, if I go with slight tilting, will come the outflow tract, the in blue. So small arch is the aortic arch, the long arch is the ductal arch. So you know they are patent. So routine cardiac evaluation at 11 to 13 plus 6 weeks should be encouraged in all NT scans that we are doing. NT more than 3.5 and ductal reversal, in these cases, they must be done. and these should be followed up. If at all you get any anomalies, then they should be followed up with early fetal echo at 17 to 18 weeks. Never forget about the extra cardiac anomalies I have already mentioned, but here again, specially because if there is a cardiac anomaly, there will be something else in the baby, and overall evaluation of the baby is important, that has to be done. So at the end, I would only like to mention is congenital heart disease represents the most common congenital fetal defects. Only 10% of fetuses with CHD present for imaging with identifiable risk factors. So here we should take all the fetuses as having potential to heart defects. So screen them properly. Screening is good if it starts as early as first trimester. It makes a huge difference when you pick up the heart defect before birth, because we know beforehand what are we going to do with the baby, where the baby is going to deliver, and what medications it will require. Experience and uniform standards for training and performance of the operators are the most important. Extended basic examination protocol can give a maximum detection rate for most of the CHDs, with fetal echo being reserved for those with abnormal basic examination. Thank you so much.